Hello, Renesia, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. This episode, we're taking a look at six mods. The animated atmosphere thruster by Math. The button pad by I3NO. The landing wheels by Krynok. The Oryx cockpit expansion by Oryx Kami. The game deco by Maxime7080. It was the memorial block by Sherbert. Oculus. And Bad SCR. Yeah, touchpad is very interesting. Very useful too. So anyway, how about we take a look at the animated atmospheric thrusters first? So, you don't add a block, it just modifies the vanilla default atmospheric thruster. The one that comes with the DLC doesn't get affected. I think it's going to be a person. You see, the blades are all spread out. In the original vanilla model, they're all closed up. You only get to see that version of it when it's at full power. So first, let's turn this on. And you see, let's just sit on. There's a button. Goes a bit. I think this angle works better. Let's get back a bit. You see, the higher we put its thrust, the more it will close up. Until it reaches its maximum, maximum position. Like that. Maybe turn it off. Oh, turn it back on. Oh, and now it off. Yeah. So anyway, that's basically all that does. Makes your atmospheric thrusters look a lot more lively than what they did prior. Which I think is pretty good for more immersive gaming. Anyway, let's next take a look at the Game Deco Bank Maxime7080, which adds this simple little thing to both small and large ships. You see, it's just a switch. That's it. Just a switch. Can't do anything with it. You can't recolor it. You can't pick it up. It's just a switch. And it only costs you 10 steel plates to make. So. Very simple. So anyway, why don't we just have a head collision mesh? Collision model. Anyway, why don't we move on to these buggers? Which are the landing wheels. They're quite simple and small. And designed to be put on aircraft or helicopters and stuff like that. They also have a simple landing gear, and they do operate as wheels. As I'll show you right now, it's only going to be this camera. Fly on over. There you go, this one. And see, when you turn left and right, it will move the wheel side to side. And when you go to accelerate and reverse, you'll rotate the wheel as well. Now both these wheels are in their default setting, meaning that the green one will only turn, while the red one will only push on propulsion. And you can't really change that. You can't change if they do one or the other. Which is unfortunate, but oh well. Don't think you really need to worry about it too much, because you put these on the bottom of your aircraft. You can use them to wheel them out onto a runway, and with the aerodynamics mod, which I did years ago, before there was even planets. Bloody hell, that was a long time ago. Maybe we should do it again, using these wheels on an aircraft. Later. Yeah, you can use these just to wheel a vehicle out onto the runway, or you take off. Useful. I got a little triplet there. Yeah, that's just basically that. So anyway, how about we move on to the next one, which is the cockpits. We have three interesting cockpits, but four blocks in total. I'll show you what I mean later. In a minute. This one is the Interceptor cockpit. With a build cast of 35 steel plates, 10 construction components, 7 motors, 8 displays, 20 computers, and 30 bulletproof glass. Yeah. So anyway, let's hop on in. You see, it's not too bad. Oh yeah, I'm still locked on. That little bugger over there. Yeah. They got some screens here. A total of 7 screens. They can customize to have whatever you want on them. Got a few buttons and stuff over there that don't really do anything. But yeah, pretty handy. Interesting little fighter cockpit, which is only 2 blocks wide. And several blocks long. And it has 2 conveyors on the back. I never checked the bottom. Why don't we do that now? And 2 conveyors on the bottom, near the front. So yeah, there's a couple of ways to attach pipes to this in order to put oxygen and hydrogen or whatever else into it. Or move bullets through it. It is meant to be for a fighter. Well, a ship that intercepts other ships. To use it to shoot down any bombers that try coming after your base. Next, we'll move on to this one. Which is the Hazardous Operations Cockpits. So more for industrial purposes. Oh yeah, integrity of this thing is just under 6,000. That's for the big bugger. A little over 16,000. It's quite a lot of durability to it. Like I expect it's for industrial work. Poor visibility, extend durability. Huh. I never really read that information for some reason. Some modders just leave it blank, but some modders do put some effort into it. Anyway, as for its build cost, it needs 120 steel plates, 10 construction components, 12 motors, 15 displays, 30 computers, 50 metal grids, and 30 bulletproof glass. Actually pretty handy on the inside. See, you have a button panel there. Got another button panel. Got a keyboard. And quite a few other LCDs. Which is handy. Depending on what you're doing. But anywho. That's that. And as for its conveyor ports, it has 1 small conveyor port on the top, a large conveyor port on the back, and if we head over to my little rubber thing, you see it's got 2 conveyor ports on, well, 2 small ones on the bottom. Which could be quite handy, depending on what you're after. But anyway, now let's move on to the ball, or the bubble. That has an integrity of only, well, just under 5,000. Yeah, it's got one mount point in the back. That's where the small conveyor port is. As for its build cost, it is 10 steel plates, 5 construction components, 3 motors, 5 displays, 20 computers, and 60 bulletproof glass. And out of all of them, it has the best visibility. But still, you know, fragile. You see, there are 5 different screens. Which you do various things with. And yeah, this screen in front is actually a different block. It's the 4th block I mentioned. Yeah, not too bad. Yeah, so there's a little block on the front. Oh, you see right here. It's the Compact Bubble Cockpit Hood. Allow you to add an additional LCD screen on the front of your ship. I selected the Artificial Horizon because I think that would be the best screen for a flight cockpit that's in this sort of shape. Which only needs 1 construction component, 1 computer, 1 display, and 1 bulletproof glass. Not sure what it needs a glass for. And its integrity, less than 100. So yeah, that thing's gonna break really damn fast. Like, so. He's already gone. I took a single bullet. What? How much freaking damage does that thing do? Clearly, a lot of someone's killed this darn thing. Oh, wait. Ah. it didn't actually kill it outright. Oh, yeah. It actually has a collision mesh. That's interesting. I'm standing on air. Well. So wait, now that we've done that, how about we move on to the next one? Which is going to be the memorial blocks. Which are basically beacons. One for female engineers and one for the male engineers. And it's basically it. Just display. The colour of the block is also represented on the suit. The suit doesn't take the same texture, as you can see. For some reason, the male engineer floating a bit higher. Not really that much of a problem. Also, the other weird thing is that they have a conveyor on the back and the bottom, despite not being functional. Not sure why, but... doesn't really matter. And they act... And they got the same code as beacons. So you change this name, you can also add what appears on the hood, like any other beacon. You also choose its range. And the build cost is 280 steel plates, 30 machine components, 20 large steel tubes, 10 computers, and 60 radio communication components. So yeah, kind of expensive, and more for just remembering the deceased. Like it says in its description. Very interesting how the picture there is also different sizes. Anyway, since there's not really much else to say about these beacons, memorials, why don't we move on to the most interesting mod among the lots? The button pad mod. You see, I've already been using it here. Having these three activate this thing, and with a few extra buttons. So it's a mod, it turns any LCD screen into a button panel. As you see with the regular square LCD, you get a total of 16. With the wide, you get 32 buttons, which is quite a lot. The see-through screen, also get 16. The text panel goes for 8. And the corner LCDs have 6. But wait, there's more! If you was to hold Control and Shift, and scroll on the mouse wheel, you can change how many buttons it has. This one being max minimum 3, and maxing out at 9. Of course, you can't go anywhere, you can't go for 7 or 8 on these things. Which is kind of weird. With this one, you can go one up, or scroll up by one, put it down to 3. Or you can do it down, put it up to 15. Yeah, they're the only three options with the text panel. This one, however, has quite a bit more. Put it down to just 9, or 4, or 1. Or you can go the other way, and put it up to 25, which is a lot of buttons. So if you need that many buttons in a single area, it's a perfect mod for it. Now obviously this one's a bit nuttier, you know, considering it's twice wide. Having a 32 here. It's 30, right? Yeah. All the way up to 50. That's a lot of buttons. And then you can go the other way, put it down to just 18, again to 10, and then to 8. And into 3, and that's as low as it goes. Yeah, pretty handy. We can easily scroll it to change how many buttons it's got. Now, what about if you want to put it on a modded block? Like say you put in a custom LCD and you want to put it on there. Well, it doesn't automatically set itself up. It only does that with vanilla, vanilla LCDs. But it is compatible with modded ones. So I've already done it over here. As you can see, this modded block has buttons on it. Now, how do you set up a modded block? Well, first of all, find the LCD you want to turn into a button panel. Let's do this one up here. You scroll down, it's up on the left. Switch it to script. And then select screen calibration. Then you hold Alt to bring up this. Although normally if you're not in a vehicle, you don't have to hold Alt. If you like, you know, like the one that showed at the front. Here, you go over to this one. Middle mouse button. Go down to this one. And middle mouse button. Go down to this one. And middle mouse button. Then you click on that one. Don't think clicking on the clipboard is actually necessary. I think that's more for putting it onto other screens of the same kind. And now that's done, you switch it to the button panel. You can see it works. Ah, you can left click when you're inside a cockpit. So yeah, you click on it, brings all the stuff up. Leave the scroll bar at the side, go up and down. And bring that back to the top. On the antenna. And then you click on and off. There you go. At the moment, you see it says a DWK review pad large. As I thought I needed a big one. Click, and I was gone. Click, and it's back. So yeah, that's an easy way to set it all up. It was allowing you to have custom buttons on custom LCDs. And since you're in a cockpit, you can just use the whole left click thing. It does make it quite convenient. So that even if you're like this, without any of the menus showing up, you can still press the buttons that you need. It won't tell you what they do. You need this up for it to tell you. Yeah, but it is actually quite handy. So yeah, that's all five of those mods. Which I think the button panel one is going to be the most useful of them all. So anyway, I will have links for all six mods down in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.